有一句话说，上帝创造了大峡谷，但是却选择把家安在圣多纳。圣多纳在什么地方？它是一个什么样的城市呢？今天所要探访的有红岩国度、灵气之乡、沙漠中的红宝石之称的美国亚利桑那州度假胜地圣多纳 （Sedona）。
Back in 1901, a gentleman named Carl Schneble, back in Missouri, had a brother out here who was teaching school, and the brother wrote to him in Missouri and said, "You should come here. It's a wonderful place, lots of opportunity." So the brother, T.C., Theodore Carl, came here and brought his lovely young wife, Sedona, with him and their two children. After they'd been here about a year,T.C. decided that he wanted to have postal service because you had to go clear to Jerome or clear to Flagstaff to get your mail back then, which is 30 miles away in either case. So he wrote to the Postmaster General of the United States. He submitted several names, but they were rather long. Finally, the postmaster said, "Send me a short name." So the brother of T.C. suggested, "Why don't you send your wife's name? It's only one word, and it's a pretty word." So in 1902, we got our post office and we got our name, Sedona.First Anglo settler arrived in 1876, and he was here about 2 years all by himself, and finally he sent for a wife. And so another family moved here, and he married their daughter, and they had 9 children. The Jordan family came here in the late 1920s when the mom and dad lost their orchard over by Jerome because of pollution from the mining operation there. And they sued and actually won a lawsuit, and they brought their money over here, and they bought this farm and some other property, and they brought sons with them, and the sons started the orcharding business here. When Walter Jordan moved here in the late 20s, he was a bachelor. Then in 1931, when he got married to the local school teacher down the road, they built this one-room cabin and they had 3 children. So 5 people lived in this house from 1931 to 1937. Oh, wow. All of the items in here belong to Mr. and Mrs. Jordan, some of the family toys.This table in the corner is kind of interesting. It's called a chuck wagon table, and it flips up and out of the way when you don't want it there. So if you were going to have a group, maybe her club ladies were coming over and she needed the place for chairs, she could get rid of the table.
So this is the
sleeping porch, but we now tell the story of T.C. and Sedona Schneble in here, who came in the early 1900s. Many of these items belong to T.C. and Sedona. Sedona did this little embroidery work herself, and her granddaughters made it into curtains for us. There is a dress in the corner that belonged to Sedona and a little dress that belonged to her daughter, who unfortunately died here. And that's the story of the Schneblies. They came, they started the post office in 1902, but they were gone by 1905 because of personal tragedy. But they did come back when they were older and lived here again until they passed away. So this room is dedicated to TC and Sedona Schnebley and the naming of our town. And the first movie made here was in 1923. It was a silent film. After that, into the 1960s, there were about 100 movies made here.
What was the most popular spot?
Well, probably the most popular spot is on here right now. Okay. But it's the western right there.
Oh, yeah.
It's the western set in West Sedona, and when you get a chance to go to West Sedona, you'll see that rock that looks like Coffee Pot Rock. Coffee Pot Rock.
Okay.
It right at the base of Coffee Pot Rock set this western movie street. So every time you see an old Sedona movie in the middle of the night on TV, if you see that Coffee Pot Rock in the background, you'll know that it was taken right there. Elvis Presley came here and made a movie in the mid-1960s. They say it was probably the worst movie he ever made. It was a modern western. In the movie, he chases cows with a Cadillac. Here's the movie poster for Elvis Presley's Stay Away Joe.
Stay away Joe, they call me Stay Away Joe. Oh yeah, but if you need me, call me a hoop and a holler and I'll be there. Ho! A hoop keeps turning up like a bad penny. I take one guess, stay away, Joe. Always finding trouble aplenty. Oh my yes, I reckon you know.
In 1947, when the family was doing well again and they built their new house and they bought their new car, they also built this brand new fruit packing shed. Here, what they did when it was peach season, which is right about now, they would bring the peaches in and they stood at a long bench over on that wall and they packed the peaches by hand. They could bring the apples in and put them in this long automated apple sorting machine. And the apple sorting machine actually weighs the apples by ounce and separates them as it goes through the machine into different sized tubs. At different times, the Jordans were the largest private employer in Sedona. Local people from little kids on up to grandma and grandpa working for the Jordans at different times because they needed so much help at different times of the year.
介绍到这里，我们先休息一下。广告过后，更多精彩的节目内容马上为您播出。 有美的令人难以置信，而且造型百变、非常奇特的梦幻红色山岩，许多的包装杂志都把它誉为是全美最美而且最壮观绮丽的地方。 来到圣多纳，如果你想要近距离的体验一下这些红色的山岩，同时一探究竟这个非常充满灵性的群山之话，那就一定要来尝试这个粉红色的越野吉普车之旅。位于圣多纳的上城区，这个地方就是我们坐上粉红吉普车的大本营。来，我们看往后面，这些全部都是这些 粉红吉普车来欢迎大家的地方。Hi, Tony.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Wow, I love the Jeep.
Isn't it gorgeous?
Yes.
Would you like to sit inside?
Sure.
All right.
It must be fun.
It is.
Driving and sitting on.
Well, you know, the guides have a lot of wonderful stories that they tell us when they come back from tour.
Really? Ooh, this is big.
Yes, it is.
I can hardly see the front.
We'll have to get you a booster seat.
How long is the ride?
Anywhere from an hour and a half to 4 hours long, depending on the tour.
Okay.
Most of them average between 2 and 2.5 hours.
Okay. Wow, 4 hours. Where do you go, like, in four?
It's actually a combination tour.
There's, like, a hiking trail?
Actually, that one includes an ancient ruin site. That's another exclusive tour for Pink Jeep. Takes you out to Hanaki Ruin. And then it includes our Diamondback Gulch tour, which is nice, rugged, four-wheeling out into the high desert.
Wow. I feel like I'm, like a safari.
Yeah, it's exciting, isn't it?
What's your favorite rock?
My favorite rock would be Cathedral Rock.
The Cathedral Rock.
If I had to say in the area, it's a great hike and it gets you up on top of everything. Beautiful views from up there.
How many different rocks out there?
Oh, there's thousands. Really? There's thousands.
You're kidding me.
Nope, each one has a name too.
Each one has a name.
I'm sure they do. Oh. Whether it's man-made or if it's,
How many do you remember?
Oh. Bell Rock, Cathedral Rock, you know, Courthouse Butte, there's Snoopy, Lucy. I can name more. I can't think of more off the top of my head.
Coffee Pot Rock? Where is it?
That's out west of town, and you would see that on our Ancient Ruin Tour, our Diamondback Gulch Tour, and our Coyote Canyon Tour.
Oh,
everybody's normally laughing and smiling when they come back.
Wow. What would be a really good season to come here?
Spring is our busiest season. Because the weather's a little cooler, hasn't quite heated up yet, and then October, November, and the fall time, once again, it gets nice and busy for us because
spring and fall is
our peak season.
Okay.
Yep.
Do you take tourists to go, like, up the mountain, like, in the winter time?
Oh, yeah. As long as the trails are safe, we take you on the trails. We really are open every day of the year except for Christmas, so...
You know. I can't wait to try it.
We'll have to get you on.
It's gonna be fun.圣宫纳不但具有天然的奇景，而且它还有灵性，所以呢，来到这个街道上，你会觉得真的是一个度假胜地。很多的诗人、艺术家还有作家都喜欢定居在这里，在这里他们可以自由自在的创作，而且这些美丽的风景会给他们很多的灵感。那么现在是午餐时刻，当然就要找一个特别具有艺术气质的餐厅来享用。
Pepperoni.
Yes, and although we almost didn't do a pepperoni because it was a little more traditional, it is, we almost didn't, but we knew we needed to, and we use a very preservative pepperoni, but this is the kids' favorite, and so we sell probably more of this, second only to the margarita.
The margarita
is the one with the fresh mozzarella and my mother's sauce.
Will you be making the margarita?
I will make the margarita in a moment. Now, this is an oven that is about 900 degrees. So what we're doing is we're using an Italian oven, the old world style of the flavor is rustic. You taste the wood. When you taste it, you will be able to tell me what's the difference. Because the difference in a conventional oven is still delicious. You've got the bread, the tomato sauce, the cheese, but that's just a pizza.
Okay.
When you taste this, you're going to taste that difference in flavor because it's rustic. It's something like you never had, and you don't even feel guilty eating it. You feel like you could just eat pizza forever because it feels natural. Let me show this to the camera.
Wow.
Rosemary, a little bit of olive oil. Yes.
It smells delicious.
Oh. So I take it, we put it right here, and voila. Rustic flatbread.
介绍到这里，我们先休息一下。广告过后，更多精彩的节目内容马上为您播出。
So this is our mother sauce, and I say that because this is the base that sets ours apart. We don't just use crushed tomatoes, we use a beautiful homemade marinara that has been the foundation of the Italian red sauces from our restaurants for 18 years. And so we make it like a little canvas, okay? And I'll let you do the next one. So we don't want very much, and I made a little spill, but that's not a problem. The messier you get, the better it is. Now, we're going to take our cheese and we're going to just crumble that cheese, okay? We don't want a lot of cheese in this style of pizza. What we want is to taste the crust. So we're going to tear it and we're going to just kind of tear it and shape it real quick. And we're going to very carefully just take our torn basil leaves.
Wow.
Okay, it's picturesque, white and green, colors of the Italian flag. Now, every pizza that we do, we're going to put a little extra virgin olive oil. And then we're going to, again, stretch our canvas before it goes in the oven to make it extra big so it can allow. And then we need to take this and we need to let it go. And voila. Okay, now we're going to put the paddle back. One moment. Get Daryl.
I'm gonna make pizza.
She's gonna make pizza. Okay.
Oh, wow. Pizza coming out.
Pizza coming out. Okay, another signature for us is that we always love to oil our crust with the extra virgin. This is a really good quality olive oil, and it makes the crust even more buttery. Touch of Parmesan Reggiano, and I don't know what more you could want.
Beautiful.
Molto buono. Pizza margherita.
Fantastic. I have to admit, and I don't cook at home.
What's the reason for that?
I'm just not good at cooking.
I don't believe you. Okay, we'll do a little recap.
Okay, we do
the fresh mother sauce, the fresh mozzarella cheese.
Okay.
You begin, and I'm going to watch you, and I'm not going to grade you.
You're not?
No. You're going to do great. Oh, wow. Fast learner.
Am I doing the right thing?
A little more, yes. You're doing the perfect thing. Now, let's take this away. Right. Now you're gonna take your cheese.
Take the cheese. Flatten it, right?
And you're gonna pull it. There you go.
Okay, three should be enough, right?
I think so. I think you have a future making pizzas. And okay. One more for good luck, okay?
Yes.
Just like you did.
How's that?
Molto buono. Perfect. Beautiful. Right. You can't put enough for me. We're going to put it into the oven just enough. Let it go gingerly. There you go. You did it.
Yes.
Brava.
When can I start working?
You've got a job, baby.
I just got fired.
She just got fired. Oh, wow. Now you want to show this like you're holding it. I think for her first attempt, I think you did pretty good.
One last touch, right?
Oh yeah, on the edge. Not okay. Too heavy, good. Reduced, and I would be very content if that was my first pizza because I burn a lot of pizzas before I got good at it. So let's try it. Okay, now the final touch. I'm sorry, but you must cut your own work of art.
Let's do it.
With gusto. Yes. Yes. Beautiful. Oh, this is going to be more delicious than any of them. Wait till you try it. That's great. Come across hard with conviction.
All right.
Great job.
This就是今天为大家做的，是我亲手做的，为大家做的本店的招牌。
Oh, I love the way your pizza turned out.
Oh, thank you.
But I have to have a little bit of chilies on mine. I like things spicy.
I have a great teacher.
You're better than me already. So good. Yours is perfect.
Thank you.